Blackstone presents A Season in Lights, a novel in three acts by Gregory Erich Phillips. This book is read by Theresa Bakken and Earl Sewell.
Prologue, March 2020. The silence was deafening. The shouts, the honks, the clatter, all gone. But the hush was anything but peaceful. The Brooklyn streets had the tomb-like silence of a hive after its bees had fled. Many things about New York City are frozen in time. I love that about this city. When we put on that show in the funky little off-Broadway theater, it could have been any time, from the 20s till now. But even New York couldn't stay frozen in time forever. Once time thawed out, it caught up fast. This pandemic would leave scars that might never heal. The city always rebounds from its tragedies. New Yorkers are resilient as hell. They rebuilt after 9/11, after the financial crisis, after Hurricane Sandy. And they would rebuild after this. But each time, something was lost. Some ones were lost, too. Usually, it was us, the artists, the musicians, the dancers, who led the way, bringing the spirit of the city back. But this thing would hit us the hardest. Many of us would be the ones who were lost. I'm not sure I even counted as one of us anymore. Less than a year ago, when the curtain fell after the opening night applause, I assumed the New York City I knew and my place in it could last forever. Chapter 1, June 2019. Hurry up, Cammie. Full cast photo. Okay, zip me up. I hustled to put myself together in the corner I had claimed in front of the green room mirror. Percy rushed over to zip up the back of my post-show little black dress. I followed him out. My stage makeup and fake eyelashes would look garish in the house lights for the cast photo, but that was all part of the fun. We gathered on the uneven wooden stage, nine of us, all feeling like the biggest stars on Broadway. Snap, snap. Here, take one with mine. I took back my phone and looked. We were a ragtag group indeed, but I smiled with joy. At least I didn't look like the oldest one in the group. It was my first cast photo since coming to New York City. I knew it would be the first of many. I returned to my corner of the green room, and the temperature spiked in the tiny chamber as everyone else piled in. It should not have been possible to fit nine people with all our costumes, shoes, props, and supplies into that glorified closet, much less for us each to have our own little space in it. Such was the intricate dance of theater we all knew so well. For each bit of action that the audience saw on stage, twice the action happened back here. It was a constant whirl of flying garments, sweaty bodies, and varying degrees of nudity, powder, glitter, champagne corks, and the fumes of hairspray. Oh, how I had missed it all. I stuffed my dance paraphernalia into my gym bag and slid it under the counter. My costumes pressed against all the others on the teetering rack, waiting for us to do it all again tomorrow. Percy gave me a sweaty hug. Honey, you were divine. It's a great show, I said.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.